Several months ago, I received a call from my mom. It was midday and I was at my office. When I answered the phone, it was immediately apparent that something was wrong. I had a hard time understanding her at first. She had been nursing the flu for several days and was a bit hoarse, but she seemed to be struggling just to catch her breath. I told her to immediately hang up and call 911, and I jumped in my car and I made the 15-minute drive to her house. By the time I arrived, the paramedics were there, and she seemed to be relaxed and breathing fine. However, when the paramedics checked her blood pressure, it was 240 over 110. My mom was suffering from a hypertensive crisis. Now, a hypertensive crisis is a severe increase in blood pressure that can lead to stroke. Extremely high blood pressure, a top number of 180 or higher, or a bottom number of 120 or higher can damage blood vessels. The blood vessels become inflamed and may leak blood or fluid. As a result, the heart may not be able to pump blood effectively. Now, causes of a hypertensive emergency include forgetting to take your blood pressure medication, stroke, heart attack, heart failure, kidney failure, rupture of your body's main artery, interactions between medications, and even convulsions during pregnancy. A hypertensive crisis is divided into two categories: urgent and emergency. In an urgent hypertensive crisis, your blood pressure is extremely high, but your doctor doesn't suspect you have any damage to your organs. In an emergency hypertensive crisis, your blood pressure is extremely high and has caused damage to your organs. An emergency hypertensive crisis can be associated with life-threatening complications. So the signs and symptoms of a hypertensive crisis that may be life-threatening may include severe chest pain, severe headache accompanied by confusion and blurred vision, nausea and vomiting, severe anxiety, shortness of breath, seizures, or unresponsiveness. If you experience a severe increase in your blood pressure, seek immediate medical attention. Treatment for hypertensive crisis may include hospitalization for treatment with oral or intravenous medications. Lucky for my mom, there's a great hospital within minutes of her house. The paramedics rushed her to the emergency room, and thankfully, she soon stabilized with no long-term damage. However, this was her first indication that she had any type of high blood pressure issues. Many aren't as fortunate and suffer cardiac arrest or stroke before they ever realize they are living with dangerously high pressure. My 70-year-old mom now walks for 30 minutes per day, has embraced a heart-healthy diet, lost 20 pounds, takes regular blood pressure medication, and takes a targeted supplement specifically designed to heal damaged blood vessels. If you're ready to attack your high blood pressure, click the link below and let's get started right now.